Agentic AI is here. What is it? Why is it so important? And what kind of impact it's going to have on your job? Leslie Joseph is here, Principal Analyst at Forrester. We're going to deep dive in, and we're here at UiPath in Las Vegas, forward number 7 already. Leslie, let's dive in. What is Agentic AI?
Sure, my pleasure. I think let's contextualize this, right? So 22 months ago, ChatGPT kind of burst upon the scene and sort of started this whole frenzy around generative AI. And at that point, we were largely doing things like prompt engineering, which was this idea that if you can shape the input that goes into a large language model just right, then you can possibly get something out of it that is useful. And it was a little bit like voodoo, because sometimes you got what you wanted, sometimes you didn't. And over time, we went through another cycle. And at the beginning of this year is when we started coming up with things like RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, which was the next cycle of evolution, the application development paradigms around LLMs and generative AI, right? And that was interesting again, because you could actually use your data, you could bring your data to the model. And so that created another era of generative AI application development. And now the frontier is essentially agentic, because it's a very new and unique idea, is that can you use AI models, but can you have them do things? So mm-hmm. it's not just about retrieving information and providing, you know, generated content to you. It's about actually making the models engage with each other, engage with the external world, engage with functions and external applications to do stuff for you. And I think that completely changes the game a little bit, because for the first time in all these months that we've been talking about generative AI, it becomes a part of the automation fabric of an enterprise rather than just something that you use as a novelty or put into chatbots and so on.
And what I understand is doing things, but start doing this autonomously. So can you explain a little bit more how it can work autonomous, how agents can work with multiple agents, how they can work with agents with humans? How does the spectrum work?
So at the start of this whole agentic revolution, a computer scientist called Dr. Andrew Ng came up with these design principles for agentic. So there were 4 design principles that he proposed, and then I added 2 of my own.
Okay.
So the 4 that he proposed was agents can plan. Mm-hmm. So if you give them a task, they can break that task up into subtasks. They can work with other agents, so multi-agent collaboration. They can work with other agents and other forms of AI to execute those tasks. They can reflect upon the plans and the output that they create to improve it and refine it and make it better. And the 4th design pattern is tool use, which means that they can work with external tools like APIs. You know how good they are at creating code. So, you know, create code and pass that code on to external functions and so on. And then I added 2 more. There's memory, which is essentially state persistence, because as you know, large language models on their own are stateless, but you can bring in state persistence using external memory, and that allows the agents to actually keep track of what they've done and create a workflow or manage a workflow as it goes through different states. And of course, autonomy, which is the idea that they can perform completely autonomously or in conjunction with humans. So that's really the bounding box that we're talking about. And that really makes agents very compelling, because now you actually not just have the capability for them to do things, but you actually give them the mechanism and the sort of the blueprint for them to act in the real world.
And can you give an example how it works in the real world, the specific role or a specific use case maybe, and how do they collaborate with humans?
So think about any long-running workflow, yeah? So think about what humans do. Let's say a researcher like myself or somebody sitting in a financial services company, investment firm, whose job involves kind of collating different data points and different pieces of information from completely different sources across the web, bringing it all together, using some proprietary data from the firm, and then bringing that together, putting all these things together and creating a report. That is a fairly complex human task that requires some elements of, you know, actual physical task execution, but also some cognitive workload that goes on top of it. And an agent can really do all of these things within that framework, that bounding box that I spoke about. So it is very possible for you to think about some of these more conceptual, cognitively heavy tasks that humans do. But now you can move these to an agentic workflow or an agentic framework. And you probably still need humans for various parts of this, like interaction and governance and so on. But the agent on its own can autonomously now do a large chunk of the work that the human used to do.
And what's the impact for you, for all the people that are watching? Is it going to change their job?
I don't know that it's going to change their jobs. Obviously, some element of job composition is going to be transformed in this whole process. But I think what people need to understand is that agents are, at the end of the day, one Lego block. We're kind of moving from a very different place in terms of the way we used to think about our tech stack, right? So the tech stack for most of the first age of digital, as I call it, was really application centric. The application was front and center. So you had an app for everything. You had an app for a CRM, you had ERPs and so on and so forth. And a few years ago, the reason why things like RPA became so popular was because the apps just didn't allow you the flexibility that you needed to build your workflows and, you know, do work the way work needed to get done. And so now with all these other Lego blocks that are coming in, we have a completely new conceptualization of the enterprise tech stack, not so much as a place with all these different siloed applications, but more like a bunch of Lego blocks. And this is what we call the automation fabric at Forrester. Yeah. And it's these Lego blocks that when you can orchestrate them and bring them together, enables this tremendous amount of flexibility in the organization. And I think that is really the big difference that it creates, because now even humans are essentially part of, you know, one, their skills are among these Lego blocks that are available to you, as are agents and as are all these other pieces of AI, machine learning and process orchestration.
I'm going to watch the agentic AI domain very closely. I'm going to follow you very closely, how the companies are going to transform with AI and especially with agentic AI. Leslie,
thank you.
Thanks a lot. And thank you for watching here from Las Vegas at UiPath Forward. Thanks and see you soon.
Thank you.